She's a commanding change within the DC National Guard, a veteran F-16 pilot, and the first woman to lead these soldiers and airmen.
You know, women weren't allowed by law to be in combat-coded aircraft. And so even when I was became familiar with the F-16, it was really not available to me until the combat exclusion laws had changed.
Contact.
That happened in the early 90s, just as Major General Sherry McCandless and her Air Force career took off.
It's the sound of freedom.
Now, sitting for her first interview, General McCandless is leading the DC National Guard at a time of dramatic transition. Troops recently finished their mission to protect the Capitol, yet some members of Congress want to bring them back. DC Guard members could become part of a small strike force helping Capitol Police if another riot unfolds. The general told us during a morning at Joint Base Andrews, a proposed Capitol strike force would not put a crippling strain on her 2,700 Guard members.
I think that the planning would need to take place, but I don't see any major changes required.
It's still unclear whether Congress will greenlight such a force, but McCandless said on day 60 of her job, she's prioritizing how the Guard can deploy to the Capitol faster.
God forbid this happens again. Do you think the Guard will be prepared to respond faster and with a different playbook than what we saw earlier back in January?
Well, what I would share with you is that, as you mentioned, I'm on my 60th day, and I've spent a lot of those days connecting with my downtown partners.
Those would be the U.S. Park Police, Capitol Police, and MPD, figuring out new ways to communicate and coordinate more effectively.
What I would tell you is there's a great amount of learning and collaboration going on at this time to ensure that if and when we have our federal or district partners that require our assistance or the assistance of the National Guard, that we're in a better place.
She adds part of the district being in a better place is the Guard reaching out to those in need. These cadets in maroon dropped out of high school, but are now back on the path to a degree and are part of the Capitol Guardian Youth Challenge Academy. It's a 5.5-month program with no obligation to join the Guard.
One more step to your left.
Cadets here focus on
physical fitness activities, understanding how to balance a checkbook, understanding, you know, the criticality of their diet and how that feeds them. And they basically learn skills that we think that will help them complete their education. Join the workforce, and then come back into the D.C. community.
McCandless is the granddaughter of an Iwo Jima veteran and says she's proud of her family tradition of service. The general adds that pride extends to the men and women under her command, and she's ready for what may lie ahead.
It's a constant evolution. We can never rest on where we are.